Hello everyone, I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and in today's Tinkershop tutorial, we're going to learn how to make patches using Inkscape with the Inkstitch extension. When first opening up Inkscape, you will notice there is a square in the middle of your page. This is known as your canvas, and anything you design within this canvas will be captured by the program. Anything that you will design outside of this canvas will not be captured by the program. So the first thing I like to do is measure my document properties and how big this canvas will be. Go up to the File menu, click on Document Properties, and a window will appear. Under Units, instead of mm, switch it to in for inches, and do this for your display units as well. I want my patch to be 3.5 inches wide, so I'm going to type in 3.5. I also want my height to be 3.5. Hit enter, and now you'll notice that your canvas has changed. It might not look like it, but right now your canvas is 3.5 by 3.5 inches. That's the size when it goes onto the embroidery machine, it will actually start stitching. The first thing I like to do is I like to import my image. I'm going to go down and select Google Chrome and search an image. When searching for images, we still want to look for a black and white image that'll be able to be converted into a vector image.
When you find your image, click on it.
I'm going to right click on my image, click Save Image As, and I'm just going to save it to the desktop. Next, I'm going to go back into my Inkscape program, click on File, Import, and I'm going to go find my image. There we go. I'm going to click OK. And now here is our image. The next step is I need to turn it into a vector, and I can do that by going up to the Path menu and clicking Trace Bitmap. Click Update, and then click OK. You should have two images. One will be transparent, and this is gonna be your good vector image. This other image, where it's blocking out the background, you can delete. Now, to make this compatible, to be used in the Inkstitch program, I need to do a few adjustments. I have to go up to the Path menu, and I actually have to click Break Apart.
I'm going to select these two objects, go up to the Path menu, and select Difference. Now you'll see it kind of cookie-cuttered out the two shapes that I want not to be embroidered.
I'm going to draw a square around my whole object, and then go up to the Path menu, go up to the Object menu, and group them together. Next, we're going to simulate and make sure that this is going to work properly. We're going to go up to Extensions, we're going to click on Inkstitch, and we're going to click on Simulate. A window should appear and give you a preview of your design right now. Click the X. Now, let's add some more to it. I'm going to draw a circle now around our ladybug. Now this looks really nice, but I'm going to make it a little thicker. I'm going to go to Stroke, Stroke Style, and I'm just going to increase the thickness. I need to actually go up to the Path menu, do Stroke to Path, Extensions, Inkstitch, and then click Simulate. We can see it's going all the way around. Perfect. Next, we're going to add some text. I'm going to get some curved text here. So I'm going to click the text tool. I'm going to type in my text. I'm going to change the font by clicking my text tool over on the right-hand side here. Let's find some fun fonts. I'm going to hit apply. And I want this text to be curved with my patch. So I'm going to click my move tool. And I'm also going to select this circle. We're going to go up to text and then put on a path. So right now we have our text, and I can click and move it around anywhere that I want, so I can adjust it. Now if I move my circle though, it's going to move my text with me, so just keep that in mind when you're designing. Go up to Path and put Object to Path. Go to Extensions, click Inkstitch, and Simulate. We want to make sure that all of our designs are working properly before we group them together. Okay. Next, I want to actually click and draw a square around my whole object. I'm going to go up to Objects, and I'm going to also hit Group. And now let's go to Extensions. We're going to simulate this once, and then we're going to embroider it. Okay, so we're going to click on Extensions, and we're going to click on Inkstitch, and we're going to click Embroider. Click Apply, and it'll automatically apply all of your objects. Lastly, we're going to save our file. We're going to go up to File, Save As, title it, and we're going to select DST. Click Save.
You've now created your own custom patch using Inkscape with the Inkstitch extension. I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and thanks for joining us. Take care.